Welcome back to the lecture series on culture studies. This video is an attempt to give a brief account on Laura Mulvey's essay, Visual Pleasure and Narrative Cinema. Laura Mulvey is a feminist, a film theorist from Britain, best known for her essay, Visual Pleasure and Narrative Cinema. Her theories are influenced by Sigmund Freud and Jacques Lacan. She uses their ideologies as political weapons and also included psychoanalysis and feminism in her works. Mulvey is predominantly known for her theory regarding sexual objectification on women in the media, more commonly known as the male gaze theory. The male gaze theory is where women in the media are viewed from the eyes of a heterosexual man and that these women are represented as passive objects of male desire. Audiences are forced to view women from the point of view of a heterosexual male, even if they are heterosexual women or homosexual men. From the feminist perspective, this theory can be viewed in three ways: how men look at women, how women look at themselves, and finally, how women look at other women. Typical examples of male gaze include medium close-up shots of women from over a man's shoulder, shots that pan and fixate on a woman's body, and scenes that frequently occur which show a man actively observing a passive woman. Being one of the most notable film theorists in the world, her ideas and clear proof of misogyny in the film opened up the eyes of many. And in 1975, something that people simply accepted was finally questioned. Mulvey states that the gender power asymmetry is a controlling force in cinema and constructed for the pleasure of the male viewer, which is deeply rooted in patriarchal ideologies and discourses. This means that the male viewer is the target audience, therefore their needs are met first, and that this problem stems from an old-fashioned male-driven society. Her theory on how women are portrayed in film and the media is just as prevalent today as it was in 1975 when her text was first published. Mulvey believes that women are in fact the bearer of meaning and not the maker of meaning, which suggests that women are not placed in a role where they can take control of a scene. Instead, they are simply put there to be observed from an objectified point of view. In addition, she believes that this way of watching film is never alternated, so that the men are in fact the ones who are being viewed in this manner. This inequality enforces the ancient and the outdated idea of men do the looking and women are to be looked at. In her essay, Visual Pleasure and Narrative Cinema, Laura Mulvey utilizes psychoanalysis theory as a political weapon to demonstrate how the patriarchic subconscious of society shapes our film watching experience and cinema itself. According to Mulvey, the cinematic text is organized along lines that are corresponding to the cultural subconscious, which is essentially patriarchic. Mulvey argues that the popularity of Hollywood films is determined and reinforced by pre-existing social patterns which have shaped the fascinating subject. Mulvey's analysis in this essay combines a semiotic methodology of cinematic means of expression with a psychoanalytic analysis of desire structures and the formation of subjectivity. The semiotic end of Mulvey's analysis enables the deciphering of how films produce the meanings they produce, while the psychoanalytic side of the article provides the link between the cinematic text and the viewer and explains his fascination through the way cinematic representations interact with his subconscious. Mulvey's main argument in Visual Pleasure and Narrative Cinema is that Hollywood narrative films use women in order to provide a pleasurable visual experience for men. The narrative film structures its gaze as masculine. The woman is always the object of a reifying gaze, not the bearer of it. This is something reminiscent of John Berger's ways of seeing. The cinematic gaze has always produced a masculine, both by means of the identification produced with the male hero and through the use of camera. Mulvey identifies two manners in which Hollywood cinema produces pleasure, manners which arise from different mental mechanisms. The first involves the objectification of the image and the second one the identification with it. Both mechanisms represent the mental desires of the male subject. The first form of pleasure relates to what Freud termed as scopophilia, or the pleasure derived from subjecting someone to one's gaze. The second form of pleasure, which operates alongside the scopophilia, is the identification with the represented character, which is brought about by needs stemming from the Freudian ego. Both mechanisms discussed are gendered. Scopophilia in films is a structure which functions on an axis of passive actor, with a man always on the active gazing side and the woman on the passive to be looked at ness side. This is done in two completing manners, with both the male figure within the digest and the camera looking at the woman and directing the viewer's objectifying gaze. In plain words, the woman in the films is meant to be looked at. The distinction between the passive woman and active man is also manifested in the structure of the cinematic narrative. The film's Mulvey surveys revolve around a dominant male figure with which the viewer can identify. This identification is similar to Lacan's mirror stage, in which the narcissistic, a fragmented subject, experiences himself as a whole and potent in a reflected self-image. Methods that produce cinematic realism aid in this mirror-like identification, which reinforces the ego. According to Mulvey, the female cinematic figure is a paradoxical one. She combines attraction with a playing on deep fears of castration. The male subconscious has two ways of escaping his fear of castration. One is the demystification of the female figure, that is, the dismantling of her mysteries. In the films where the female figure is punished or saved by the male figure, the other way to escape fear of being castrated by the woman is through the fetishization of her, for instance, as a glamorous, unobtainable star. Films, according to Mulvey, attempt to resolve the tension between being attracted to the woman and fearing her, and therefore they provide for the needs of the masculine form of desire. Mulvey's visual pleasure and narrative cinema was criticized on one hand for reinforcing heterosexuality and on the other hand for assuming a passive, unnegotiating viewer. However, it is clear that Mulvey's theory can be applied to a vast amount of films. Mulvey has shone a light on the old-fashioned and repetitive style of cinema we see every day, and her ideologies have helped to create a more modern and truthful version of cinema, as we now have more realistic portrayals of women than ever before. For example, the films like A Spy, The Hunger Games, etc., which allows audiences to have a refreshing look at women in strong and powerful positions without a man by their side, thus enforcing the important message that women do not have to be put in box and objectified. They can play a variety of different versatile roles, and they can be considered through the eyes of the society in a way that doesn't patronize and sexualize them via male gaze. Thank you.